Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Mark with Limo Marketer, and in today's video, I want to talk about this. Does it make the car go faster? And so you're probably like, what the hell are you talking about? What does that mean? And what it means is, well, let me give you a story. So yesterday, I was signing up a new customer. And great operator, very nice person out of Cleveland. And so I was going into the different packages and I told her which one I thought was best for her business, just the smallest one because, you know, she's still relatively small, only had a few vehicles, and but a lot of potential for growth. And so she agreed and she wanted to move forward with that package. And then, you know, she started asking about, do you handle any sort of Facebook or Instagram, or will you be doing any like blog posting or adding photos to my website? And I told her pretty much no on every single account. And I'm not saying that those things are not a good idea, but you have to ask yourself, where are you at in your business today? And if you're a smaller operator, if you're still driving, I don't want you worrying about your Facebook profile or your Instagram profile or any sort of social media profile. I don't want you to waste your time on blog posts. All that matters right now in your business, and I'm talking to small operators right here, if you're doing seven figures a year, I would consider you a larger operator. And once you get to a certain size, I get it, having those things does make you look more legitimate. And I'm not saying not to have them. I think it's a good idea to have them. They don't take long to set up and it can make you look a little more legitimate. However, what I am saying is this, is once they're set up, those profiles, I want you to forget about them. Because all that matters is getting more clients. And to get more clients, we need to get more leads. And to get more leads, you should be using Google or Bing search. Those are going to be your two best platforms. The only caveat is if you own one or two stretch limos, can you have success with Facebook and Instagram? Yes, you can. You have to make an offer, you know, you have to maybe offer $100, $150 off a ride, and you can target people with birthdays, anniversaries coming up. And so you might pay less per lead. I've actually found you do. I've found, you know, leads on Facebook can be $4 or $5. However, the problem is they're not actively searching for the service. So you might not book that business right then. There's a good chance you'll convert a decent number of them in the next year. But if that's all you're doing, you're really slowing your growth. You need to be using Google or Bing search, pay-per-click, because really from day one, you can put your ads in front of people that are actively searching for your services. But what about SEO, Mark? I think SEO is great. However, if you have only $1,000 a month marketing budget, I want you to forget about SEO. Okay, I don't want you to even think about SEO until that $1,000 budget is $5,000, $6,000, $7,000 a month. Then we can start thinking about other things. In the beginning, the problem I see with most operators is they're told, you know, many times by gurus who seem to know everything, you need to do all these things, and do you have a Facebook? No, you don't need any of that, okay? You don't even need a website. All you need is a landing page and a traffic source like Google Ads or Microsoft Bing Ads. And what you need to do is get as many leads as you can for as little money as possible and close the highest percentage of those leads as you can. That's it. I don't want you thinking about anything else until you're making 50 grand a month. Once you're at that point, then it gives you options. And so this is what I had discussed with the operator, and it wasn't even that she was saying, oh, I want to do those things. She was just really curious if those were other services that were offered. And I told her, I really just focus on the things that I know 100% right away will give you a return on your investment. Because I know for myself, my business to be successful, I need to make you guys successful. And I know if I spent, you know, the retainers that I was given each month doing blog posts for you, you know, doing posts on Facebook and Instagram and, you know, tweeting, you know, it would be a complete waste of your resources. You do not have resources to waste. You need to funnel every cent you have into pay-per-click ads, get as many leads as you can, and then once you have those leads, you need to close the highest percentage possible. And just getting good at selling and negotiating and fielding leads, and that right there will make you much more money than you'll ever make driving. Because remember, you only make as much driving as you would pay someone else to do that job. So short video today, guys. Does it make the car go faster? And so I guess that's kind of a metaphor, is that increasing your revenue? Because in the beginning, when you're low on funds, which I'm sure a lot of people watching this video, you might not have a lot of money to spend right now. And so you need to focus that energy, that money, into something that's going to get you an immediate return on your investment. SEO is a great investment. It just takes a very long time. And if you only have $500, $1,000 a month to play with for marketing, it should not be being spent on SEO, because that's going to take a long time to work. And another thing, if you choose the wrong agency and they don't know what they're doing, then that money's just going to be wasted. And if they're quoting you $100 a month, it's still, you know, and they're offering SEO for $100 a month, you're just throwing away that $100 a month. You're not getting anything. So anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Please subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next week.